Now that we have our map drawn, we need to draw circles representing our attendance data on top of it. The first step in doing this is to actually load our attendance data. Remember, we used our initial D3 JSON load function to load the GeoJSON data, but we never loaded the attendance data that we've been working with all along. In order to load our attendance data, we can do exactly what we have previously done, in this case, using an intermediate data transform function to convert our attendance to an integer and our date to a JavaScript date object, which we will then pass to a function as a callback that I've defined as plot points. The plot points function is going to act similarly to the draw function of previous lessons that gets passed a single argument, in this case data, which corresponds to our attendance data. And inside of it, we will put the code that will draw the circles corresponding to the attendance of each World Cup. The only difference from what we've done before is that we're actually calling a D3 data loading function, in this case D3.tsv, inside of our other callback function, which loads the GeoJSON. This is perfectly all right and simply has the effect of saying, first load my map data with D3.json, world countries, GeoJSON, and once that file is loaded, call the draw function, passing the GeoJSON data to it, and then inside of the draw function, we make another call to a data loading function, in this case, D3.tsv, that says, when you get to this line of the draw function, load the World Cup GeoTSV file, and once that file is loaded, call the plot points function. So the order of which these functions is called is the following. First, D3.json is called to load world countries, which gets passed to draw, and inside of draw, towards the end, we call D3.tsv, which asynchronously loads the World Cup data for the attendances, and once that file is loaded, gets passed to the plot points function. And in theory, if we wanted to do more data loading, we can simply put another call to d3.json or d3.tsv inside of our plot points and can nest these somewhat infinitely, but I would say it's a bad practice to go too far deep down this nesting of callbacks.